Hey folks, just want to showcase how you can take a website or a URL, and from that you can generate these use cases. And based on those use cases, you can generate blog posts. And in a few seconds, you can generate a bunch of blog posts that can probably go for a month worth of content for you. So here's an example of a blog post that I recently posted for Brainy Docs. Brainy Docs is something that helps you go from a PDF to video. So this technique helped me find out use cases and then write article for that. It all starts with a web form, and this form you provide the website name or your product name. Give it a few URLs. It could be something from your website. It could be maybe a blog post that you have written, and based on that you submit the form. Once that happens, it goes to N8N, and the setup right now is that form sends some information over. So we had the blog URLs that goes to this feature extraction agent. And this feature extraction agent is something I set up in LangFlow. It's pretty simple. I just took one of these text blocks that's available, so you can search for the text input. And in here I said, okay, use the website above, and there's some description saying that, okay, generate a list of use cases based on the website provided. And then what I'm doing is I'm bringing in a URL block that's available in the components, and I gave it two different URLs for now. Again, of course, you can send as many as you like from the N8N flow. So once we have both of these available, in my prompt, what I've said is that there is reference one, reference two in this case, and then I have some instructions, and then I said your response should only be features. So what I'm looking over here is just to pull all the features available of this particular product or website. And that is using Groq, and we send the prompt over. It goes to Llama 3 70B model, and from there we get some response back. And this response basically is a bunch of features from this particular website. Something real quick I want to talk about: how you can connect N8N with LangFlow. So there are these blocks which are HTTP blocks. So for example, if I were to select plus here, then you can search either API or you can search HTTP request. So what these blocks do is they help you configure any call outside of N8N. So this could be post, get, whatever it is. And the way we're going to know which call it is going to be, these parameters here, is if you go to your LangFlow, and in here, once you have the app available or the flow available, you can just look at this API button, and in here you'll have the parameters that we need. So for example, we're going to take this particular URL, we're going to bring it back here, and then we can add to the URL parameter and authentication. Since I don't have any authentication on the LangFlow app, it should work fine without anything. And then in the body parameters, it's JSON. Since I know over here I can see that it's a JSON that we're sending for the parameters to the app. Now in here there are a couple of things. I'm sending a few URLs from the N8N app. So the way I'm going to know how I can add the URLs is I can go to the tweaks here, I can look at the URL input here, I can add some values here, and then I could probably say XYZ. And if I were to go back, then I'll notice that it already gave me these URLs parameter and including the block that I'm calling. And that's exactly what I did over here. I added the JSON as an expression here. So if I were to look, I'll see that, you know, there's tweaks and there's the block and the URLs. And that's pretty much exactly like here. We have the tweaks parameter and everything else, since it's default that we're using, I'm not going to change any of that. I'll just take the tweaks. I'll add the block that I'm going to be changing, and in that I'm going to add the URLs or whatever I'm setting in as values. And once we do that, then you can test. And once you test, if you were to have some data from before, then this is going to be green and you'll see some values in here. So it's always nice to test. You can run the first step and then kind of go sequentially so you can know which one is working. Since I already did that, I have the working flow So I know that all of this is going to work fine. So next thing what happens is we send the features extracted to a use case agent. This is another agent that I created within LangFlow. And the goal here is to take all of the features that we generated in the previous step and based on that come up with 5 new use cases. So I'm doing 5 new use cases at a time. You could go more or less. And the goal over here is to generate something new. So we want the feature list. This is the new ones. And we also want to provide all of the previous ones. So we don't want to generate the same ones again and again. And once we do that, then we send it again over to the Groq API. And we're calling Llama 3 again. And then in this case, we get use cases. Once we get the use cases, then we go to some editing over here and we get the use case list. And what I'm doing over here is I'm saving the use case to Google Sheets so that we have a feel of what's happening at that particular stage. So then we get a few use cases for Brainy Docs saying that travel agencies could use them or could be used by pharmaceutical companies or different type of use cases that it can come up with. So that's looking very good. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take that use case. So I'm taking each one at a time and then I'm sending it over to the blog writer agent. Now the blog writer agent, it takes the product name, it takes the features, it takes the use cases, and then its job is to write down in markdown format a blog article. I asked it to provide something which is SEO optimized, and based on that it is now going to generate a blog article. Again, I sent it over to Groq and I used Llama 370B, and then once we hit run we should get a nicely written blog post, and this is the format that it generated for me. And now I can pretty much take this. It has the title, it has the paragraphs, it has the subtitles, and then I can post it or I can save it. So what I did over here is I saved it in the Google Sheet. I have 5-10 articles at a time, and then if needed we can add a step over here in N8N to directly post to either Medium or Ghost or any of the blogging platforms that you prefer. And at the end, when you post it, it looks really nice, something like this. I added a picture over here just for visual purposes, but you can just leave as is or add some sort of visual elements to it. I hope you like it. Let me know if you have a use case in mind that we could cover in this series. I'm gonna go over a variety of examples, and all of these are something that you can apply practically for your business or your organization or your team. Hope you enjoy this.